Hey, Machu.
Just open up your headphone.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Come
here, buddy.
Hi.
Nah, I take it you're a big bird lover.
I'm a big raptor lover.
Me too.
Yeah, I am totally... I started off as a, quote, birder until I saw my first red tail. Okay. And I haven't been the same since.
All right. We normally will sometimes see some bald eagles here on the farm, which is pretty cool. We have them coming in. Once he goes back in his box, let's pull out the box here.
See, I didn't know I was going to get to try out of these before. What we were going to do. No, I thought you were going to just like show me around and introduce me that way. Wow.
Down at our facilities in Goshen, we will kind of take people kind of to see some of the birds. Right now, during breeding season, we don't really take you down to the barns and stuff like that because you can't really disturb the birds. I just look a little to the left. You're right, my left. All right. So he's a little bit heavier. You know when he gets a little tiring, I'll take him back.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Tuck your elbow in. You can bring him real close.
Okay.
You can pet. Switch spots just while I'm on the towel.
Sure. Yeah. How close is too close for photos?
They're right up in there.
He's okay with this?
Yep. So Boogie was bred by us as well. We have his parents as well. We've had him since basically day one as an egg. And he's been doing all these sort of educational things for us basically since the beginning.
Do you have to train them a specific way if they're going to deal with crowds and children and all that?
Just that it's no different than any other animal. Just have to expose them as much as possible. Get them used to it as early as possible, but just expose them to as much situations and they just calm down. Same with dogs or cats or anything like that. If you want a really good dog that you can bring everywhere, you got to kind of bring it everywhere to get used to the situation. when he comes in, so the way his feathers are, the feathers actually have, and actually you can kind of see it a little bit, just those tiny little, like...
I see that, like little bristles.
Yep.
Yeah.
So he has the same sort of thing, microscopic little bristles on the tops and bottoms of all the feathers.
Here's a little piece of meat. This is a little day-old chicken.
All right, hold that just like that. So you're going to kind of hold it out like there, so it's got like a perfect branch for her to come fly on. She's going to come right to this spot right here, so just watch that. She's coming.
Okay. This is like bucket list stuff.
I'm glad to hear
Oh my god. Got a strong grip too.
Oh yeah.
This is amazing.
So it's just a little bit different just how they go about things. The falcons are much more like the owls are so without food being there, they'll just kind of sit very, very easily. Whereas the falcons are just kind of more aggressive.
Yeah, I mean, he's moving all over the place.
Yeah. So, yeah, from the moment you grab them, they're immediately like, all right, this is my spot. You know, I'll grab on tight. And then as soon as food's involved, just look out. And this next time should be a little bit better. Let me give you another piece of meat.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Hey, you. Should I give her a push or no? Okay. Sorry. Oh, I don't have anything for you. I'm sorry.
Back down at their flying weight again.
No, I'm laughing because in the photo, I got a close up of her beak. It's just like it's covered in feather and gores.
Is a hair hawk. This one we call boomerang.
Boomerang.
And you'll see. She's an immature female, and the other one I have is an adult female, and you'll see the difference in the colors between the two. She's got like kind of these streaking kind of patterns on her front there, and then kind of like more kind of ripple patterns on the back and stuff like that, which is a lot different than the adult females. She's completely solid colors everywhere.
Are they normally this loud?
The young ones are. She's a baby still, basically.
She's still a baby?
Well, she's still in her first year, so she's still begging for food from basically the other hawks or me.
Is she petable or no?
Yeah, you can pet her. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have you hold her.
Okay.
Open up your hand for me. Stick that right in there. Just hold on tight to her. If she tries to jump or anything, just keep a good hold on her.
Want to hear something to say? She doesn't feel as heavy as the falcon.
It's just like different kind of body. They're actually about the same weight.
Doesn't feel like it though.
It's just the way the falcon kind of sits. She's just more like denser. So these hawks are the only hawks that hunt in packs like wolves.
I am sorry.
You're okay. She's fine. These are the only hawks that hunt like in packs like wolves, so we can hunt multiple at one time.
So these are the only ones in the world that hunt in teams?
Yep. You will see birds, and I call it opportunistic hunting. If you go to like migration spots and you see some peregrines kind of migrating along the Hudson River and stuff, you might see two together, and you might actually see them kind of go for something together. But as I say, it's opportunistic hunting. One will go for something. And like...
Wow.
Enough in which you could.
But... No, I mean for the fox hunt.
Oh, I'm not involved in the fox hunt.
Okay.
So you can let me know.
Look at you!
Just kind of, so like I said, there's native squirrels and rabbits around here, so we'll just kind of walk kind of through the grass.
Okay. This doesn't grow old, man. This does not get old. Oh, man.
Hey, in Central Asia, as a nomadic tribe, we're walking through a field. Not too dissimilar to this, there'd just be no trees anywhere. But basically it'd just be rolling hills, just of grassland, no trees anywhere. And we're walking along and we come across a golden eagle's nest. And there, where they live, they nest on the ground because like I said, there's no trees or anything for them to nest anywhere else. So as a nomadic person, I see this golden eagle and I say, oh, you know what? Those chicks that she just flew away from and left there, they look pretty good. I think I'll eat them, you know? So then come back the next year, go looking for the golden eagle's nest. And instead of the chicks being there, the mother had just brought back a rabbit for the chicks. And she flies away and it's like, well, rather than take the chicks off, I'll just take this rabbit that she just left, you know? So more likely than not, what we think happened was over time, the golden eagle actually started bringing back two rabbits. And leaving one basically for the human that was coming to steal her food and catching another one for her baby.
That's amazing.
Alive. And eventually what basically the golden eagles taught the humans was that rather than stealing the babies, rather than stealing the food that the parents caught, why not steal the parent that's catching all the food? Little snack because she's being so good.
Okay, you. Hey, she took.
He said when we get down to the last little bit as part of the reward, we'll call him down to the fist and feed him up a bunch.
Awesome. Biting her own nail.
Just cleaning it off, basically.
Sometimes she's just looking for a free ride, you know? She doesn't feel like, she knows that we're walking around, she doesn't feel like flying herself, so she just comes.
You'd be a terrible actor, you can't wait until you say cut. You